Since joining the tour in 1993, Jim Furyk has been one of its most consistent performers. Jim has won 7 PGA Tour events and has won at least one tour event each season since 1998. His favorite town seems to be Las Vegas, where he has won the Las Vegas Invitational 3 times. He's an avid follower of the Pittsburgh Steelers, and he and his wife Tabitha live in Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida.
Jim Furyk has proven in his play on the PGA Tour that he can hold it from anywhere. Now it's up to you to see if you can match him shot for shot in this round of the World Tour. That's unfortunate.
Yeah, okay, we're heading straight for the trap here. All right, we're at a burial here, and there's only one mourner. She's gonna have a tough play. This is in the thick grass.
This to have the hole.
Way to make par there.
While relatively short, the second hole at Spyglass plays uphill and is surrounded by trouble, primarily sand and... David, what's the situation?
About 110 yards to the hole here, Gary. Looks wide right, but should settle in the green.
Oh,
really like the look of this shot. Looking at a big birdie putt here. There's a wonderful... She's in very good shape here. Very nicely done. Fourth hole is Robert Trent Jones Sr.'s favorite par 4 because of its many options. If the hole is in the back of the green, the approach should be played from the right side of the fairway. If in front, then the left side is the better angle. The green, which is encircled by ice plant, is Spyglass Hill's most photographed.
This one split the fairway. It's a beauty. Fairway Ferry, what do you have?
Inside 100 yards, expect to see this one go close. When the dust settles, this one just might creep on the green. That's looking good. Ooh, it's looking really good.
The fifth hole at Spyglass Hill is a straightforward par 3, framed by ice plant in back and three pot bunkers in front, the center being the deepest and most difficult on the court. That'll be in good shape.
Should be in good shape here. Looking to walk away with birdie on this hole.
Way up and down for fun.
This one for a half.
The character of Spyglass Hill changes from the sixth hole onward. From the tee, players wind their way up and into the Del Monte Forest. The view from behind the green is spectacular. However, the severely downhill chip shot from this... ball going for serious distance.
Stuff. Yeah, we should be putting now. Regular rangefinders, this is in the deep duty. Angling for a birdie here. An easy putt, gentle left swing, not too much outside the hole.
This for a half.
Makes his par.
Mm-hmm. elevated tee makes the seventh hole a reachable par 5. While there are no greenside bunkers, a pond penalizes anything left and short. The right to left sloping green makes chip and pitch shots even more troublesome. This is a tempting hole off the tee, but it requires complete precision from the fairway.
That's heading straight for the agua. Headed nicely for the green.
No shot of the day, but it's on the green. This to save par.
Well, not a particularly long putt, not a short one either.
The eighth hole is perhaps the longest hole under 400 yards in the world. The second shot is even more uphill than the tee shot. The green is elevated and crowned with a hole's only bunker protecting its right side. This is Spyglass Hill's number one handicap hole, and it plays like it.
Going for a maximum par, Gary.
Flying to the right.
If it wasn't for bad luck, you'd have no luck at all.
Hold the 7-iron here. He's hit this really well.
Beautiful effort. Don't get much better than that. That's what you want. Nice birdie. Really birdie.
This one will have the hole.
The inward hole in the front nine at Spyglass Hill is yet another uphill par four. A massive green, the second largest on the course, is guarded by deep bunkers. The tremendous slope from back to front makes putting from above the hole an unenviable task here. The cord, look at this one fly. Beautiful looking shot.
More distance on this.
That ball's got eyes, and it's homing in right on the target. No, this is just miles from home, Gary.
This putt should have the hole. Found the hole for a nice birdie there.
After two tough, lengthy uphill par fours close to the front, this is a downhill getaway hole to begin the back nine at Spyglass Hill. A drive down the left side may be blocked by a tree which can't be seen from the tee. Any approach which lands past the center of the green will...
Right where it's supposed to be, down the middle.
What's the situation there, dude?
We're way above the hole. We're shooting downhill, so picking the club will be awkward.
Should hang on to the green. This one needs to roll quite a bit.
Beautiful putt. Nicely done for Paul. This one to have the hole.
Gets his point.
The 11th at Spyglass is a dogleg right.
Dim 30. I don't know if we're going to have a go at the green from way back here. Almost 245 yards, Gary.
Heading for the rough.
Oh no, he yanked that one, and here it is, deep in the jungle.
This for an eagle three.
Water comes into play on three of the next four holes, starting with a par 3 12. The left side of this green should never be a target, since balls have a tendency to spin off into...
Is going right at it.
Well, I wonder if that was the right one. What a shot. This one will have the hole. Finds the cut for a birdie there. The 13th fairway. Attempted to get as much out of this shot as possible.
tough break here, Tony Vuloff.
That's going to be short. Not a terrible shot.
Pitching wedge.
Furyk has his sights set on a birdie here.
Inverts his paw.
The 14th hole at Spyglass Hill is a double dogleg par 5, swinging right and then left. A pawn protects the right side of this shallow but very wide green. A difficult chip awaits those who are too aggressive and go long.
This looks good, it's down the middle.
Almost 300 yards from here, David.
That's right. Get out your binoculars. It's a long way to the hole.
And this will end up on the putting surface.
Couldn't have planned it any better.
The Jim Furyk will pick up an eagle here if he gets this one to drop.
Okay,
Can you believe this?
The 15th is...
Great shot. He's got to be pleased by this. Nothing wrong with this approach.
This putt for birdie. Was in. That's a birdie. The drive on the maximum power in this one.
Hit this one right on the money, and I think he knows it. Simply splendid right there. Remarkable.
The 17th of Spyglass Hill offers a change of pace and is unlike any other hole out here. Neither the landing area from the tee nor the green surface from the fairway can be seen. The hole's many bunkers and a sloping green offset the short yardage. Hit it straight.
Yeah, that'll make it a little tougher. It's in the tall stuff. Well, this ball's got the radar turned on.
That's just a wonderful shot.
I think we're finding the bunker here. Couldn't have planned it any better.
It just burns the edge. She would have done more with the first putt, but it's still a putt. the 18th tee points toward the right fairway bunker, so a slight right-to-left trajectory is perfect. An elevated green with a ridge separating front from the back awaits the second shot. Any dodgy-looking second shot will probably be detoured into the surrounding trouble. Good ball here, David. This should work out great.
On target today, hitting every fairway. David Faraday, what do you see?
I just had a walk off this one, and it's about 160, I think. This one's in good shape. Nothing wrong with that.
This to win the match.